They said that those with expired COPR and PR visa, that's confirmation of permanent residence and permanent residence visas, and you're coming from the United States, you can come to Canada and land in Canada. Of course, there's certain requirements that you have to meet. Number one, welcome back to our YouTube channel. My name is Taiwo Olalere. I'm a Canadian immigration lawyer in Ottawa. I'm also a law partner at Olalere Law Office, a Canadian immigration law firm. We've been in existence for the past 15 years, helping people to come to Canada. If you're a returning subscriber, please tell your friends about us. We really appreciate you coming back. If you're new to this YouTube channel, please don't forget to subscribe. That way you get regular updates about Canadian immigration. I've received so many questions in the past week regarding Canadian immigration. I'll be answering some of them today. One of the questions is, the answer is yes, this is good news. You know, on July 29, 2020, the Canadian government put in a policy program instructions under the COVID-19 program instructions. They said that those with expired COPR and PR visa, that's confirmation of permanent residence and permanent residence visas, and you're coming from the United States, you can come to Canada and land in Canada. Of course, there's certain requirements that you have to meet. Number one, your application must have been approved. Number two, you have a plan to settle and live in Canada. So those people who are coming here to temporarily settle here and return back to their country, this policy won't apply to you. You have to be able to demonstrate that you plan to settle and live inside Canada. The third thing is that you have to agree to quarantine yourself for 14 days. You have to quarantine yourself for 14 days in Canada. The Canadian government is going to enforce this. This is very, very important for health and safety of Canadians and permanent residents, including you too. So what do I mean by, you know, settle and live in Canada? The Canadian government is going to be looking for evidence that you have an accommodation in Canada. So for example, do you have a lease agreement? Do you have a rental agreement? Do you have a home or home ownership in Canada? You have to be able to present evidence of that when you're coming to Canada. Second, when you talk about quarantining yourself for 14 days, so the Canadian government is going to be looking at, do you have a, you know, a plan of support during this quarantine period? So do you have bank statements? Do you have credit card statements showing that you'll be able to support yourself during this quarantine period? So those are some of the things they'll be looking at. There's a lot of things you need to keep in mind. So please contact our office for a consultation, a detailed 1-hour consultation, whereby we'll be able to provide you insight, detailed insight into what you need to keep in mind before you make that travel to Canada. It's really commendable that, you know, the government of Canada has put in this policy. It's really, really commendable. I really, really appreciate it. And I know a lot of people appreciate it as well. For those of you who have enjoyed this YouTube video, I believe everyone has, please don't forget to subscribe and tell your friends about us, okay? So we look forward to your like buttons, your shares, and your comments below. I really want to know what you think about this policy change.